Okay, for this video, I'll be discussing electronic evidence. Okay, so to give you background, ang tanong naman dito is, yung electronic evidence ba? Yung evidence from social media like Facebook, Twitter, Messenger, okay, WhatsApp, ay admissible as evidence. Yung CCTV footage, admissible as evidence ba yun? Yung mga videos, no? Audio messages, telephone conversation, o di kaya yung chatroom sessions, streaming audio, streaming video, admissible ba as evidence yun? Okay, so we will discuss it here in rules on electronic evidence. So, our rules on electronic evidence is Administrative Matter 01-7-01SC. And this is promulgated by, of course, the Supreme Court. And sabi ng Supreme Court, the rules on electronic evidence shall apply to all criminal, civil actions, and proceedings, as well as quasi-judicial and administrative cases. So, almost in all cases, admissible talaga ang rules on electronic evidence. Okay. Ano mga electronic evidence? We have electronic data message. This refers to information. Information here could be picture or messages, okay? Posts. It is generated, sent, and received in or stored by electronic, optical, and similar means. So, ito kailangan kasi, para makonsider yung electronic data message, it is generated, ginawa siya sa computer, sinend siya sa computer, na-receive or na-stored sa computer. Okay, so yan yung electronic data message. Like, for example, this one, this is a number. So, probably, this is cell phone conversation. Text messages to. So, is text messages and electronic data message? Yes. Kasi ginawa siya sa computer, na-send siya sa computer, na-receive ng computer. By the way, cell phone is considered computer. Okay, ito. This is messenger. Ang conversation ba sa messenger ay electronic data message? Actually, yes. Because again, ginawa siya sa computer, na-receive, na-send sa computer, na-receive ng computer, and that is electronic data message. Okay, kung mail pa kayo sa Gmail, no? Yung mail, electronic mail or email, Gmail, email, Yahoo Mail, or electronic data message. Kasi again, no, ginawa siya sa computer, sinend siya sa computer, na-receive sa computer, then that's electronic data message. Lahat dito kasi soft, walang hard copy. Kaya nga, in one Supreme Court case, MCC, Industrial Sales Corporation versus Ssangyong Corporation, sabi ng Supreme Court dito, fax or faxes are not electronic data message. Fax are not electronic data message. Ano ba yung example ng fax? Interesting. If you're a buyer, you want to buy something, you will make a purchase order. Nakalagay doon anong bibilin mo, gano, or anong quantity, or quality. Tapos itong purchase order na to, isi-send mo yan sa fax machine. Tapos ma-receive ng yan ng supplier. Okay? And in this order into internal system, then bill point invoice, ito yung resibo. Bill point invoice, parang resibo yan. Yung resibo or invoice ay isi-send naman niya back to the buyer through fax machine pa rin. Through fax machine. Now, so sir, basically, may physical ano ba sila? May physical contact ba? Wala, no? If you're going to look at it, parang all happen in a computer. No? Pero sabi ng Supreme Court, hindi siya makonsider na electronic data message kasi may hard copy. Ito hard copy ito. Diba? Ito hard copy ito. Ito hard copy. Ito hard copy. Kasi lahat kailangan, it is generated, sent, received ng computer. Walang hard copy. Kailangan lahat soft. Okay? Kailangan lahat soft. So, fax is not electronic data message. Settled niya ng Supreme Court. Now, electronic document. Refers to information or representation of it could be information, data, figure, symbols, o other mode of written expression, okay, describe or whatever is presented, ito, tinan nyo. Ito ang tatanong nyo, by which right is established or obligation extinguished? Okay, right is established or obligation is extinguished. Okay. Uso kasi ngayon, yung in anything na nasa picture, nasa cellphone natin, na mga pictures, pinipicture natin, nasa messenger natin, those are electronic document. If we save that as a picture. Okay? Ngayon, marami ngayon online selling o barter online. Yung bang transaction yun sa online, is that electronic document? Actually, yes. Because in online selling, a right is established or obligation is extinguished. Okay, kasi may ano yan, may ikaw ko lang right yan or obligation, no, na magbabayad ka. Okay? At ma-deliver, kailangan ma-deliver yung item, di ba? So ito yung document yun. So ito example, barter, done. Oh, yan. Mga ilang pre-love items gaya ng kotse. Alahas, pinagpalit sa ibang bagay like bigas at gulay, no? Bigas at gulay, no? Kotse, may kotse ka na. Anyway, yung barter transaction na yan, done online, online barter, is this covered by electronic document? Yes. Yung transaction yung electronic document yun. Okay, another thing, if you want to buy something in Zalora, di ba, online ano to, platform to, na you can buy something, no? Sa mga platform to, yung sa Lazada, Shopee, eBay, Amazon, okay? Yung mga transaction nyo dyan, those could be considered as electronic document. Electronic document yan mo yan. Now, ano naman electronic signature? Ito refers to any distinctive mark. Kahit anong mark, X ba yan, Y ba yan, or your name, no? Characteristics. It could be a combination ng name ng shota mo, like Aldab, Catnail, ano pa ang combination, Lisken, no? Characteristics, no? Sound or electronic form representing the identity of the person. Ito talaga, the purpose here is you represent the identity of person. Kahit nga sa mga posts sa Facebook ngayon, may mga ano na, no? May mga signature na. Hashtag, no? Mga hashtag-hashtag. That could be an electronic signature. Now, anong purpose ng itong signature? Adopted by such person with intention of authenticating, o oh, ako may gawa yan, no? Signing or approving the electronic data message or electronic document. So, yung electronic signature. Especially in mga transaction. Like, for example, this one. Ito ay isang example ng email. O, oh, kung mahilig pa kayo sa email. At bottom portion na ito yung message mo. At bottom portion kaya yan, keep in touch. O, di kay, all the best, Mike. Itong Mike na to, ay consider natin yan na electronic signature already. That's already the signature. Kung nakalagay dyan, X, it's already the signature. Okay, that is your signature. Ito naman, pag may contract, may confidentiality clause, you will need to sign in a computer, submit done, then that's electronic signature. Electronic signature yan. Now, ano naman ang ephemeral electronic communication? Ephemeral electronic communication, these are telephone conversations, okay, telephone, cell phone, pwede yan, text messages, chat room sessions, streaming audio, gusto yung streaming, no? Streaming video, no? May mga lalaw na naka-stream na ngayon, and other electronic forms of communication. Evidence of which is not recorded or retained. So, most likely, hindi nakaka-record or na-retain, no? Anyway, ito yung blooper ng Make It With You na ano, no? Teleserye. Si Katya parang naka-video call, pero yung tinatawagan niya, si Liza Soberano, ay nakatawag, no? So, ito yung blooper. Now, ito pagtawag na to, is this covered by ephemeral electronic communication? Yes, that's telephone conversation. Yung video calling could be an electronic form of communication. Video calling, video call. Okay? Now, ito ay video nung, actually this is live streaming. Live streaming sa Facebook. Kasi sa New Zealand, may isang white person doon na namaril sa loob ng isang mosque. Dalawang mosque pala. And I think he killed more or less 52 people. 52 Muslims yung nakapatay niya doon. Okay? And that killing sa mosque was live in Facebook. And that is streaming video. Is it admissible evidence? Actually, yes. Pwede yun. Okay? Because it is called ephemeral electronic communication. Ephemeral electronic communication. Ngayon, admissibility, okay, admissible. Kailan ba, o paano ba maging admissible ang isang electronic evidence? Electronic documents or evidence is admissible if it complies with the rules of admissibility, prescribed by the rules, and the laws, and authenticated. Okay? It must be authenticated by the manner prescribed by the rules. Okay? Paano ba natin authenticate yung mga text message, mga post sa Facebook? Well, we have no mga expert. Forensic expert on digital artifacts, mga digital forensics. So, pwede yung mga expert, pwede mag-authenticate yan. Ito, totoo to. Ito, galing sa website na to. Ito, galing sa account na to. Okay? So, that's digital forensics. Okay. Sino pa pwede mag-authenticate? For example, this is an example of ito. Uso ngayon, group chat. ito ay group chat ni na Britney Spears, Ana, I don't know sino Ana, Nicki Minaj, na apat sila, bestie for life. Now, sino pwede mag-authenticate ng conversation na to? Yung nasa group chat, kung sino yung nasa group chat, siya yung pwede mag-authenticate. Okay, hindi mo kailangan mag-expert kasi you're part of the group chat, so you can authenticate. Pero yung taong hindi part sa group chat, hindi pwede mag-authenticate yan. So that's admissibility. Now, sino bang may burden proof sa admissibility, no? Mag-authenticate? The person seeking to introduce electronic document, okay, that person, no, yung seeking to introduce that electronic evidence, in any legal proceeding has the burden of proving its authenticity in a manner provided by the rules. So, if you want to, ito yung judge, you want to present evidence from Twitter, from call, or from messages. So, ikaw yung nag-introduce yan, ikaw yung may burden of proving na i-authenticate yan, na totoo yan. Okay? That's burden of proving of authenticity. Tala nito, tala yan. 17 anyos na babae, inireklamo ang umano'y pambabastos at paninirang puri sa kanya sa internet ng isang lalaki at dalawang guro. Now, medyo blurred yung conversation, yung trend dito. Anyway, now, so, who will authenticate the conversation or the post? Of course, yung taong nag-post, yung taong nakabasa, o yung may-ari ng wall kung saan pinost yun. Okay? So, that's a authentication. No? Now, sino pwede mag authenticate ng audio, video, and similar evidence? Okay, ito. Audio, photographic, and video evidence of events, acts, or transactions shall be admissible provided it shall be shown, ipakita sa court, presented, and displayed in court. Okay? So, yung mga ano daw, audio, recording, photographic, or video evidence, pwede yung admissible yan. Pero kailangan mong ipakita yan, presented, displayed in court. And hindi lang yan. Kailangan siyang i-identify, i-explain, i-authenticate by the person who made the recording. Kung sino yung gumawa ng recording, siya yung mag-authenticate niyan. And by some other person competent to testify in a crazy drop. Okay, yung tao na sa video, pwede mag-authenticate niya kasi competent to testify. Yung expert, sabihin na yung walang editing to, no? Then that's authentication, no? So, example ito, pambibiktima na magnanakaw sa tindahan ng alas na huli cam. So, this is CCTV footage ng pagnanakaw. Na ang tanong, ang CCTV footage ito ay admissible evidence? Actually, yes. Pero kailangan, it must be identified, explained, and authenticated by the person who made the recording. So, sino ba yung person made the recording dito? Possible yung CCTV operator or yung nagmimaintain ng CCTV. Sabi niya, oh, walang binago dyan, walang editing dyan. Okay? Another video, tinan nyo. Ito yung video ng sabi ng UFO or Unidentified Flying Objects. Oh, and it was released by Pentagon. Actually, inutuntikit nila ito eh. Sabi nila, oh, totoo yung lumipad na yan. Pero hindi natin masabi na spaceship ng ibang planeta. Hindi natin alam kung ano yan. Pero totoo yung lumipad, pero hindi pa natin makonfirm if it is a spaceship. Kinonfirm yan. Sino nag-confirm? Sino nag-authenticate? Yung piloto ng aeroplano na kung nakakuha ng video na yan. Siya ay dapat yung mag-identify, mag-explain, mag-authenticate sa video na yan. Okay. Efferal to the communication. Ito yung communication, remember? Yung sender, receiver, no? Caller, at saka receiver. No? Efferal to the communication shall be proven by testimony of person who is a party to the same. So, sino pwede mag-authenticate ng mga communication, ephemeral electronic communication, yung party to the communication or person who has personal knowledge. Yung tao may personal knowledge. Okay? And absence of the ability thereof, any competent evidence may be admitted, like expert testimony. Kasi ganito, di ba? How SMS works, yung text message? Well, mobile exchange message. Ito, nag-send. Pupunta yan sa centralized SMSC, babalik yan sa receiver. Ito, receiver. So, sino ang pwede mag-authenticate sa ephemeral communication? Yung sender o di kaya yung receiver? Kasi sila yung party ng communication. Yan yung party to the same, no? Or has personal knowledge. Ito. Ito yung nag-viral, no? Na akala ni Kuya, American to, no? Kaya English-English siya. Hindi pala. Filipino at marunong mag-Tagalog, no? So, sabi niya, Stan, I need your body, no? So, now, this is video call. Who can authenticate this video call? Well, of course, yung, silang dalawa, no? Pwede mag-authenticate niyan, or other person who has personal knowledge. Kung merong ibang tao na nakakita yung pag-conversation nila, pwede. Okay? O, ito na to. Online trial. No? Yung trial nga, ginawa ng online. Si judge, mga si ito clerk, no? Ito yung accused, ito yung abogado, I don't know. Now, sino pwede mag-authenticate sa video na to? Yung involved sa video, sino na sa video? Sila. Or other competent evidence may be admitted. Okay? Now, in this case, no, Rustan Ang versus Court of Appeals. Rustan Ang, ito yung kaso ng magsyota na nag-break up. No? So, anong nangyari dito? Rustan courted Irish, mag-boyfriend, girlfriend siya, Rustan saka Irish. They become on-off sweethearts towards the end of 2004. When Irish learned afterwards that Rustan had taken a live-in partner, may live-in partner pala si Rustan, whom now his wife, whom he gotten pregnant, nabuntis yung live-in partner ni Rustan, syempre, nag-arit si Irish. Irish broke up with him. Nakipag-broke up si Irish sa kanya. Pero, gusto ni Rustan na magbalikan sila. Okay? In the early morning of June 5, 2005, Irish received a multimedia message. Ito yung MMS. Kasi dati, pag mag-send ka ng picture, MMS yan, medyo mahal yan, 5 pesos or 10 pesos yata. Anong MMS yun? Ito yung picture of a naked woman with spread legs like an eagle wings. Okay? Kayo nang bahala mag-imagine yun, boys. Ano yung picture of a naked woman with spread legs like an eagle wings? And with Irish face superimposed on the figure. So may figure na isang babaeng gumutubad, kabukaka yung legs niya like an eagle wings. Tapos nilagay yung mukha ni Irish. Sinden niya, nirustan kay Irish. At tinakot siya, no? After she got the obscene picture, yung bastos na picture, Irish got another text message from Rustan. Madali lang ikalat yun. May chatroom ang tarlak, right? Pwede ring isend sa lahat ng chatter. Okay? So, tinakot siya. Kasi gusto ni Rustan makibalikan kay Irish. Now, actually, nahuli si Rustan, kinasuhan ng violence against women. Now, ang tanong dyan, pwede ba magamit yung picture of a naked woman with spread legs like an eagle wings as evidence? So, yes, pwede. Sino mag-authenticate? Yung party sa conversation, pwede si Irish, pwede si Rustan. So, malamang it will be authenticated by Irish, totoong natanggap niya yun. Okay, that's authentication. So, let's come to the portion where we will try to answer some questions. Application sa na-discuss natin. Okay. Number one, under the rules of electronic evidence, ephemeral electronic conversation or communication refers to the following, except. So, ang tanong dyan, except eh. So, kung ma-except yan, you encircle the except, no? Text message, telephone conversation, fax document, online chatroom session. So, this is fax document. Fax document are ephemeral electronic conversation or communication. A fax document is not ephemeral to conversation kasi nga may hard copy dyan, no? That is settled by the Supreme Court. Number two, it refers to information generated, sent, or received, or stored by electronic, optical, similar means. So, ginawa siya sa computer, na-send sa computer, na-receive sa computer, ang tawag dyan ay EDM, or electronic data message. Okay? Electronic data message. 3. Electronic document shall be regarded as equivalent of original document under the best evidence rule if it is print out, output, readable by sight and other means. Okay? So, actually, this is a general rule, no? Electronic document is equivalent to original document. Yan yung sabi sa batas natin. And that is wholly true. Wholly true yan. No? Electronic document is functional equivalent to original document. Number 4, it refers to telephone conversation, text messages, chatroom sessions, streaming audio, streaming video, and other forms of communication of evidence which is not recorded or retained. So, this is what we call the EEC or ephemeral electronic communication. Okay, so telephone conversation, text messages, chat room session. 5. Patrolman Eugene acted as pusher buyer in a bypass operation, contacted the pusher buyer through messenger, okay, messenger, that he will purchase 50,000 worth of shabu. The pusher agreed and they decided to meet along Duterte Avenue. After the transaction was consummated, Patrolman Eugene, together with his backup, immediately arrested the pusher. Among the items recovered from the pusher are 5 sachets of shabu, marked money, and cellular phone. Is a cellular phone admissible sa evidence? Ayun yung tanong, cellular phone, admissible ba sa evidence sa drugs yung kaso? Actually, yes. If it can be authenticated by the party to the conversation. Remember, cell phone or cellular phone was used in the transaction. Diba may transaction dun na bibili siya ng shabu? So that's ephemeral electronic communication. Basta kailangan lang i-authenticate siya ng party sa conversation. Pwede sinong party sa conversation? Si Patrolman Eugene at saka yung pusher. So malamang sino yung mag-authenticate niyan? Si Patrolman Eugene. Okay? 6. The following can authenticate ephemeral electronic communication. Except, sino dyan hindi pwedeng mag-authenticate ng ephemeral electronic communication? Party to the communication, yung receiver sender or yung caller or yung receiver. Pwede, no? Person with personal knowledge, pwede. Expert witness, pwede. Ang hindi pwede, yung ordinary police officer. Hindi lahat ng police officer pwede mag-authenticate ng ephemeral electronic communication. Lalo na kung hindi siya party there to. 7. In a robbery with homicide case, the prosecution presented a CCTV footage showing how the accused perpetrated the crime. Will the court consider this footage as evidence? Pwede ba makonsider ang CCTV footage as evidence? Yun yung tanong. Okay? Letter A, yes. As long as it can be explained or negated by a person who made the recording. Letter B, yes. As long as it can be shown, displayed, and explained in court by any person. C, no, because we have no expert in videography. No, because videos can be edited. The best answer is, of course, letter A. As long as it can be explained, it can be authenticated by the person who made the recording, not by any person. Ito yung mali. By any person. Mali yan. Okay? Mali yan. So, I think that's the last portion of my discussion on electronic evidence.